has been filled with drama. Hade is on Facebook ranting every second of the day. This chick clearly has no work, no job. She's a mother and a husband. But for some strange reason, she spends all her time ranting about me. Zari is also doing the same thing. By the way, I have to thank the two of you, Judith Hard, and everybody, Brenda Nambi, I don't know, everyone who has been ranting on Facebook, on social media, everywhere about me. You guys are the reason I'm now flying high. Yes, I'm confirming this. I've been invited to South Africa to host the Star Cutie Awards and all that because you people have made me famous with your rant. And I'll be traveling to New York very soon and to DC. So I'm going places. Thanks to all your rants on social media. Keep them up. My name is Mary Luswata. Welcome to the show. And speaking of social media, my Twitter handle is @Taswalu and my Facebook page is Mary Luswata. Remember to leave me a note. Otherwise, we are getting the show started. Now, Lumasi has kept a low profile ever since. She's trying to do haka music here and there. She's a mother. We heard things about her and what went wrong with her husband. Apparently, he was jailed out there. And that she's trying hard to move on with her life. And she's doing quite well musically. Well, she doesn't have a rich man to invest in her videos. But she has managed to, you know, stay on top of her game. Not exactly on top, Sheila top. I mean, Sheba top. But she's surviving quite well. And I like some of her music. So I don't understand why a fan would decide to reach out for her flower. The story is she had to slap some guy while she was performing because he reached out to touch her. And I'm thinking to myself, Renna never dresses indecently. She's always dressed very well on stage. So if anybody had to reach out for any flower, they had to. It should be Sheba's. Sheba is the one who is literally fronting it and throwing it into people's faces. She should be the ones whose thing they are pulling, not Renna's. I mean, look at people like Cindy. Cindy dresses to show the shape of her samosa. Sumbusa, you know it is like that. She wears swimsuits. Why don't you reach out for that one? Because clearly she wants it to be touched. They should be bullying people who are asking for this kind of attention. Cindy, Sheba, Irene Nambiru, for her, she just put it there one day like this and some guy touched and she didn't even look like one, moved even a second. So touch those people's flowers. Leave decent people alone. Now, if I would be really angry if somebody reached out to tap Judith Babidia's flower, I would slap that guy as well. Because, man, she's not showing anything. She's just doing her innocent gospel music. The same thing with Rema. It might not be gospel, rather, but she's not dressed indecently. She's not asking for this kind of assault. Tap Sheba, tap Cindy, tap the rest of them all. You should have touched Brenda Nambi as well, but no one is asking her to perform anywhere. Because, anyway, why? Because, it's very clear. Who would want to listen to that? Nothing. Well, maybe but Leila Kayondo. Guys, I've been wondering one thing. Where does Leila perform? I know that ads run on radio and TV stations and there are all kinds of names announced everywhere. But have you ever, even for once in your life, heard that Leila Kayondo will be performing somewhere? Tell me, I have never heard her name being mentioned anywhere. It's like she's a musician who does only videos but never really is, you know, called to do any stage performances. Never on any big shows, not anywhere at all. And yet she spends so much money paying Chameleon and Good Life to do collabos. And where is she? Oh, Leila, someone lied to you. They need to tell you the truth. You're not worth that much money. You should be given 100K. Or even 70 or 50, I don't know. First of all, you need to have, you need the stage attention. Pina Masanyaze has a new man. Have you heard? Yeah, apparently she could have moved on with some guy, some light-skinned guy who, if you gave him a weave, he would pass for a chick. I've seen him. His name is Obambo DJ Western. I think so. I think that's what he's called. He has some Luganda name. I don't quite remember it. But yes, well, compared to Fina, Cindy is a little refined. Yeah, and please note that Cindy went to Barracks, Police Barracks Primary School, and also went to Mbale High. But clearly, compared to Masanyaze, she's like the refined version. Masanyaze! From what we see, she's trying so hard to be something that she's not. And akazungu tekali yo. There's no English. So maybe Muyisa just said, oh, I'm not settling. Let me go for Cindy. Cindy might also be like a village girl who has been happy, but lucky, but anyway, no. I feel like she has met her match. Because when I look at this guy is But also women. I mean, you don't come from Ken Muyisa and even go to DJ Western. What are you going to get from this guy? Listen to the name, first of all. DJ Western. And then the way he looks. You know, he reminds me of these guys who make Rolexes. Someone has said, Mufina Mazanyaze is booked on free to air and Cindy is booked on DSTV. Kanzi's problems seem to be piling up day after day. See, you know, he has a pregnant chick who was slapped and robbed at his concert and who everybody's saying was not at the concert, but she was in a lodge somewhere with Warukaga. I don't even know how that happens. There was a headline that says that she was in a lodge with Warukaga while her man was hosting his concert. I don't know. I was not there. The first time I heard that Rema had slept with Warukaga, I swear, I said, I will put my hand there. Someone said, Mary. She did. Walukaga hit it. He bought her laptop and he hit it. She served it to him on a laptop like this. I said, no, you guys are lying. They said, she has given it to him. I said, Ugandan girls, no, not Walukaga. So anyway, the story is all the misfortunes that that seem to be chasing after Kenzo lately. He, Mbu, was asked by somebody last year during Christmas to perform somewhere in Makindye, one of those Christmas concerts. And I think there were so many, he failed to perform at this particular one. So this promoter had paid him 600,000, which Kenzo refused to refund, yeah? So the guy went to court and he sued Kenzo and sued him for four million in damages. So the judge actually rewarded this guy 4 million and Kenzo was supposed to pay fine. And up to today, he has never paid him even 1 shilling. So maybe Walukaga, Ologamu no. Is there witchcraft in this industry? Because Kenzo, people are about to be in the show lately. Everyone is talking about you. I mean, you have become like a Kansimi of some sort. And it's a wrap, people. Thank you. Thank you so much for being a part of the show. I enjoy doing this show again and again and again. And I intend to do it for a very long time. So keep locked. My name is Mary Deswater. This is Urban TV, where all the cool stuff starts. You can join me at 2, at 5, and at 10 p.m. for a lot more. Otherwise, mwah, I love you. Take care. Bye.